ill-advised feed intercepted by Hood. Arkansas, first possession. Bradley, a three-pointer way off.
Did not have the legs underneath him and drifting away from the basket.
Oliver on a dish off. Extra feed settles in some traffic. McCausland thought about it for three. This is Oliver. Got it.
Nice job, though, by McCausland. Just a little ball fake brought two defenders to him. Lob.
Back the other way. Jeffries couldn't finish it, but Bradley with the offensive rebound. 1 minute gone by here in the first half in Iowa with a 3-0 lead.
Jeffries has started out pretty well the last two games that he's played in also.
Long three for Reed. Back iron. And a foul called as McCausland was shoved from behind. Chris Jeffries called on the personal foul. Both teams shot the ball well from three-point range in their first-round game. Iowa was 12 of 23. Arkansas, 15 of 30. Oliver breaking down the defense and drawing the foul. It appeared to be Jeffries once again.
He and Oliver were struggling the other night. Side effects of the flu, but what you do and what you have on the floor is a guy who knows how to put it on the floor. As a lefty, he throws a little different look at you, and right down the middle, quickly going towards the basket in your right eye, and it was Jeffries there, so two fouls on him, a difficult start to this basketball game for him.
And Dean Oliver at the free throw line. Give credit to Oliver, who actually spent some time in the hospital earlier this week, hooked up to an IV, came out with 15 points and 6 assists off the bench in the win over UAB 77-64, and he has scored all 5 of Iowa's points. Walker a 3, booked
it. Barely moved the net on that. Nice job by the Arkansas team going right past that long full court trap that Iowa set up that trip.
2-point lead for Iowa.
Look at how far out on the floor they come to defend. Question becomes, how long can they do it for? They're a well-conditioned squad.
Bauer finds an opening. Tried to get the feet over to Koch, and Bauer is called on an offensive foul.
Jeffries was the guy standing in his way, taking a chance defensively there with two fouls, but he gets away with it, picks up a charge.
For complete tournament coverage with live scores, stats, and more, check out Tournament Live only at cbs.sportsline.com or America Online, keyword CBS Sports Live. Good step in by Bauer for the steal. Lersman now in the game. Nearly a backcourt violation as Lersman saved it. Dean Oliver getting a breather. Lersman trying to break down Kareem Reed. Shot clock at 15. Bauer on a double team.
Look at the defensive effort, though. It is solid. The intensity right there at the beginning. Got to go the other way with that one.
Derek Hood looked over to his left at Kareem Reed and then shuffled the feet for the travel violation.
Nolan Richardson likes the up-tempo, obviously, at the offensive end also. You have to give some credit for Iowa just then getting back, forcing the action defensively.
Joey Range comes on for Iowa, replacing Jason Bauer. A 5-3 Hawkeyes lead, 17:34 to play first half. Knocked her out off of Jeffries. Out of bounds. The Arkansas Razorbacks, they have tasted what a championship is all about. 1994. One of the hotter teams in the nation coming out of the SEC and peaking at the right time. Joey Range putting it off the window.
Pretty set with some good movement from out of bounds. Joey Range had to tuck the ball away.
Look out. Jeffries had to catch it. Rejected by Koch.
The pass being so high allowed Koch an opportunity to get back for the second opportunity.
Ryan Lersman. He lost the ball out of bounds, but it came off of Walker. So Iowa will retain possession with 27 on the clock.
Arkansas double teams. They look for trap opportunities, and then the guys who are not involved have to read situations.
Iowa 2 of 2 from the field to open play. They lead it by 4. Lersman comes to the ball. Penetration, dish off. Koch couldn't catch it. And a 4th turnover for Iowa in the early going. Walker, open look. Second drive, Becton.
When Iowa has turned the basketball over in bad situations, Arkansas has come down and made them pay for it.
7-6, Iowa, range. A little bit out of control, he tried to save it. Walker stepped in front. Hood running the break, and Iowa gets back defensively. Reed on a spin move, that's pretty. Fight for it underneath, and Hood couldn't get the roll. Joey Raines the rebound in traffic.
Hood struggling a little bit with a hip problem.
Lersman accelerating to the rim. He gave up his body, and Jeffries took it. Offensive foul, second time.
Coming right at you. You go up, you look away, but look at Jeffries sliding in. Jeffries has taken two chances defensively with two fouls. And that's a bang-bang type of call from the official. Sliding in there, you have to be so careful with that. Nolan Richardson giving him a little break. Pretty good work at the defensive end. Here's that full court pressure, just a slow Arkansas down. It doesn't look like it's working.
Reed on a dish off, and Range was there. Oliver has returned for Iowa, and Brandon Dean now out there for Arkansas. He's called for the foul. The Iowa Hawkeyes, three Final Fours, the last time came in 1980. Well, this is a team that has been unable to get out of the second round. Six consecutive second round losses in the NCAA tournament. They went to the Sweet 16 under head coach Tom Davis back in 1988, but since then it's been the second round blues.
And they just have to control the tempo and make good decisions. High screen here for the big fella, Jakes.
That's Jacob Jakes, who just checked in. Guy Rucker out there as well, as Iowa goes big up front, and they turn it over.
I know Iowa has this lead, but they don't look real comfortable.
Timeout, 15:49 to play first half, a one-point Iowa advantage.
Saturn Coupe has better pickup than a Maserati. After a Little League game, anyway. The world's first three-door coupe. From Saturn. Why didn't anyone think of this before?
In the financial world, to survive, you must keep on the move. It is not a world for the hesitant or the timid. Sometimes, to defend against larger, fiercer competitors, your best choice is merger or acquisition. But beware, lest your careful, well-planned strategy should result instead in failure or doom. In these troubled waters, experience, knowledge, and size are your best allies. If you're considering strengthening your company through merger or acquisition, think first of First Union. Wherever you plan to go, we have been there before. Come to the mountain called First Union. Or if you prefer, the mountain will come to you.
Napoleon, Alexander the Great, Donald Trump, we're all cut from the same cloth, and that cloth is very, very large.
It's not too big, is it?
No.
Turn left on Trump Avenue.
Ever wonder why New Yorkers have such big mouths?
Go big or go home.
Because we eat big pizza, like the big New Yorker from Pizza Hut.
16 inches of real New York pizza dripping with cheese at a very un-New York price.
$9.99. They've got to be losing money on this.
The big New Yorker, new from Pizza Hut, is beautiful.
At Daytona, Jeff Gordon and Dale Earnhardt battle to the bitter end. Now these Winston Cup warriors get primed for CBS's next race, the Prime Star 500.
7-6, Iowa with the lead here early in the first half. Right now, let's check in with Mike Mayock.
Hey, Ian, thanks very much. Just prior to tip, I talked with head coach Tom Davis. He said as the pressure intensifies in this tournament, you've got to keep your poise. And there's a perception that Arkansas is the quicker team and Iowa is more of a power team. He said, let's get one thing straight. We have better athletes than people think. And Ian, I think that'll be sorely tested later this afternoon.
Well, Tom Davis should know his 11th overall NCAA tournament appearance. And his team now with a one-point lead. They are 2 of 2 from the field, but they've committed 7 turnovers. Bradley, long distance shot for 3. Out of bounds.
Richardson has said also at the other end as Tom Davis positions his team at the defensive end. Nolan Richardson has said when we hit the long three-point shot, we were a totally different team. It helps our defense out actually also. They're getting some looks. Currently 2-for-5 from the floor long range.
Davis thought it came off of Arkansas, but the Razorbacks will hold on to it. Looking for the lead. Walker has 2 3-pointers already here today. Another open look. Short.
Have to get a hand up there, so they have to contest these three-point shots.
Bradley came away with the offensive rebound. Dean from the other side. Can't hit the three. Hood had it bounced off his head. And Iowa controls it. Joey Range driving. Counted in a foul.
Joey Range using the body on the break. It's 6'5", 200 pounds. Takes it down the floor. Uses the power at the end of this play. Goes down. Watch him tuck that ball. He'll come to the left side. Tuck it away from the defender. Once the defender goes by you and tries to miss and misses on the ball, that's when you bring it back up. Uses the strength to get it to go.
He is a very physical player, a true freshman from Galesburg, Illinois. 10-6, Iowa.
Iowa in the full court just to slow them down a bit.
And Walker lost control of it as Jakes came away with it.
Tom Davis mentioned his decisions against Arkansas. The same is true for Nolan Richardson's squad.
Inside Rucker, a brick.
Look at him work down deep.
And it came off of Arkansas out of bounds.
Nice effort there by Jakes. Working the offensive glass, getting a hand in there to keep it alive. Jakes right in the middle going against two of the Arkansas players. He 3-4 times gets the basketball. That might have been his foot, though, it went off.
Officials didn't see it that way. Rucker, as Reed went for the steal and a reach-in foul called. It is Kareem Reed. Let's reset the lineups for you. Reed, Cleveland, Dean, Hood, and Bradley for Arkansas. It's Jakes, Rucker, Oliver, Bauer, and Range for Iowa.
When Arkansas double teams, you take a look at the numbers, a slow start shooting the basketball for them, 11 field goal attempts. They make their decisions, they're instructed that if you see a double teaming opportunity, go for it, and then the other three guys, their job is to react in the back row of players.
McCausland comes in replacing Ballard. Dean Oliver, the sophomore. Oliver, the jump shot. Rebounded by Jakes, and he's fouled.
One of the things Iowa continues to do is try to bring this game down deep. They can shoot the ball from long range. With their success level, it'll open up the perimeter if they can drag people down to the blocks and into the paint area. Four across here. They sometimes will go for a lob. So you have four guys across the bottom of the floor down by the baseline. See if they try for a lob. It's not there. Well defended.
Iowa has been aggressive, though. 16 fouls on Arkansas. The next one will put Iowa in the bonus.
And look at how much time is left in this first half. 14 minutes and change. It's a good situation for Iowa.
Swarming defense from Arkansas. Settles the jump shot. No good. Range tried to follow it as he scooped it with the right hand. Cleveland gives it up. Kareem Reed, that slingshot delivery. Rimming out. Knocked up in the air for Jakes. 10-6, Iowa.
Arkansas may have to test the same thing down in the paint.
Crossover. Oliver gives it up. McCausland for three. Rebounded on the weak side by Bradley. He tracked it down.
Oh, maybe a double dribble?
Yep. Arkansas turns it over. The premiere of Pain coming up on CBS Monday after Raymond as John LaRoquette returns to television as an innkeeper with an attitude. That's Pain right here on CBS. Arkansas with that unforced error, but Iowa still leads the category 7-5 in turnovers. Lursman back in there. The leaner. He draws the foul.
See, that's a pretty good decision. They're going to force Iowa to use the basketball on the floor, and they have to make good decisions. The best part of that decision for Lorsman, though, was he pulled up for a little jumper rather than running over somebody at the end of the play.
Ryan Lorsman. He got can play either guard position. You'll see him back up Oliver, or then shift over and play the two-guard spot. He is a perimeter presence, shooting 38% from three-point range, a junior out of Cedar Rapids, Iowa. And he gets the roll. Arkansas wasting little time. This is Cleveland. Five-point lead for Iowa.
That full-court presence by Iowa has not allowed Arkansas to come down the floor and get easy buckets, though. That's one of the keys.
Sir Gario Gibson, another one of those Arkansas freshmen, now on the floor. Brandon Dean gives it up for Hood, who's yet to get involved offensively. Dean with 10 to shoot, using a lot of the clock. Dean, that quick first step, he couldn't finish it. Hood couldn't grab it. Knocked out of bounds. Who's got it? Arkansas does with a new shot clock.
A good judgment by Dean with the shot clock going down. John Davis continues to shuttle people in and out. He's going to keep the fresh bodies in there, even though the tempo has not gotten out of control as of yet.
J.R. Koch in for Jacob Jace. Arkansas, no field goals over the last 3:48. They are 2 of 13 overall.
They shot so well from the outside. In their first round game, sometimes you can lull yourself into believing that that's all we should be looking for, a long range shot. They've got to use their speed to get into that lane area, break some people down. That'll open the perimeter for them.
Cleveland penetration.
Nobody's going for it except Iowa.
McCausland, the pull-up pop. High arcing shot as he knocks it down.
Great recognition there because that's not an automatic backcourt.
Lead feed, Kareem Reed working his way to the interior.
There's a little show of the Arkansas offense.
13-8, Iowa. Bauer back in there. Koch gave up the dribble, and he just pulled Cleveland down to the ground. Foul call.
Sometimes when the ball goes backcourt, the offensive team thinks, well, it's backcourt, it's going to be a violation. Nice little run down. McCausland goes way upstairs. A little drifted, but Arkansas answered back in a hurry.
J.R. Koch called for the foul. Arkansas with a quick 7 on the board for team fouls. Sir Gario Gibson for 3. Short. The Arkansas Razorbacks, who played their first round game with relative ease, trying to get much tougher here against Iowa. Nice cut to the basket by Bauer.
Great decision off the ball, too. And Iowa looks very, very comfortable, and they're controlling the tempo because they're not giving up the quick transition offense.
15-8, Hawkeyes. Jeffries guarded by Settles.
I don't think they can settle to the outside. Here we go.
Walker driving it to the basket, and he draws the foul. Bauer spilled to the floor. And Chris Walker is going to the free throw line.
The double team out front. You have a situation where backdoor works, even from the power side to the weak side, if guys are rotating on the defensive end.
J.R. Koch picks up his second personal foul. Walker shoots at 67%, a gutsy player, a former walk-on who earned his scholarship at Arkansas from Pine Bluff. Had some other offers, but decided he wanted to play basketball for the Razorbacks, and he stuck it out.
Team nicknamed him the Creep because he gets everything done in a silent fashion. He's pretty active so far.
Another free throw for Walker. He's got it, and a timeout. 11:43 to play, first half. It's 15-10, Hawkeyes.
Oh, yeah, those first ice boats had a lot of speed, but not a whole lot of control. Yeah, with the blades that nearly couldn't steer around the ice fishing holes. Oh, geez, learn the hard way. Wider is better.
With its speed-sensitive steering technology, the Whitetrack Grand Prix gives you precise cornering and control, even at a good clip.
You betcha. Braider air, better.
Wider is better. The Whitetrack Grand Prix by Pontiac.
Morning, Frank.
Morning.
How do you plan on funding your retirement? Conseco's annuities and mutual funds can help. Conseco, step up.
Oh, man, it's early.
Did they test through to the router?
We're merging two totally different bank networks.
Gotta work seamlessly. Seamless.
AT&T says it's ready to go.
Either gonna be the hero today, or... or hiding in the John, right?
Hero. Yeah.
Everyone and everything working together in a whole new way.
Give it up! Your colonel's got the moves this NCAA season, because my popcorn chicken's back at KFC. Crunchy morsels of tender white meat, try some for $1.99. Go, Colonel. Go, Colonel. The colonel, he's the man.
Stuck with a flat tire? Not with this tire. Even with no air pressure, you drive to safety. Aquasteel Run Flat. Don't get stuck. Get there.
Hi.
When your new co-workers obey, how do you tell your wife?
How was your training?
Sheesh. I got a good one.
An all-new King of Queens, CBS Monday.
Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg at our studios here in New York. And while we keep that score at the bottom of your screen, let's take you around the country and tell you what's happening first in Indianapolis, where Oklahoma State and Auburn started out like a house of fire, Clark. Auburn shooting 41% from the field. The winner of this game will play the winner of the Detroit-Ohio State game on Thursday in Knoxville.
Well, Oklahoma State, Greg, has the ability to be able to attack the pressure. As you can see, Auburn is pulling out of it because they play primarily three or four guards. With that, you can spread the floor and you can get your shooters good shots.
Alex Weber, the Oklahoma State center, saddled with three fouls already.
Adrian Peterson, he and Desmond Mason both had big games. Peterson there showing you his game with his back to the basket. Comfortable pace for Oklahoma State here. Auburn would much rather play up-tempo. Oklahoma State looking to shorten the game a little bit and maximize every possession.
Meanwhile, at the Key Arena in Seattle, Gonzaga and Stanford and the Bulldogs have been on top from the early going in this one.
Remember now, the other day they started very quickly against Minnesota, had to fight off a furious charge in the second half, and I think what we're seeing happening now, Greg, Gonzaga got off to the good start, but Stanford starting to wear them down. At the 8-minute mark, Stanford was already in the bonus shooting foul shots on every common foul.
I know as we were watching this game early on, Clark, you said watch the rebounding in this game.
And surprisingly, Gonzaga had stayed even, actually was out-rebounding Stanford in the first 9-10 minutes of this game, but that size has a cumulative effect on you over the course of a game.
All right, Clark, let's take you back to Denver now. McNichols Sports Arena, 5th seed at Iowa, 4th seed Arkansas. Let's rejoin Ian Eagle and Jim Spanarkel.
Iowa has led this one from the beginning. Bradley, a three-pointer off the mark. Had some action on the inside, a loose ball foul. The Iowa Hawkeyes come in as the 5 seed. Arkansas coming off a very impressive win over Siena, but so far, not only have the Hawkeyes not backed down, they've gone right at Arkansas.
They sure have, and the thing about it, too, is that Arkansas has not shot the three well at all. They're just struggling from long range. The looks are there. They're not getting them to drop. And Iowa's being pretty patient at the offensive end.
Foul called on Joe Dean Davenport. Talented freshman Chris Jeffries is on the bench after picking up his third personal foul. 1-1 for J.R. Koch. And he will get the second free throw. But his team in front by 6.
And already Arkansas at 9 team fouls. Plenty of time left in the half at 10:53.
Koch out of Morton, Illinois.
The only way that becomes effective, that number, though, the team foul situation favoring Iowa, is that if you take the ball to the basket more frequently than what you would normally do, you want to take advantage of it, get to the line.
Lorsman is in for McCausland, and Iowa has a 17-10 advantage. On the outside, Reed. He's been held in check. Oliver going for the steal. Kareem Reed gives it up. Bradley couldn't catch it. Ball knocked around. Oliver scrambling for it. Calls the timeout for Iowa.
He had the ball tucked underneath his stomach, and before he gathered it in, he was trying to get a timeout. Watch, the ball's going to roll right to his belly now. He doesn't have it. It's still under, but he's looking up to the official to call a timeout. That's a great awareness play by Dean Oliver.
Wise beyond his years. Just a sophomore. 22nd timeout. 17-10. Iowa with the lead. 10:34 to play here in the first half. Denver, Colorado. UConn has already advanced to the Sweet 16. The advantage coming up on the midway point of the first half. Settles had it blocked away. Rebounded by Walker. Pat Bradley defended by Oliver. Walker out on the perimeter. This is Fuller. Drive on Koch. Settles the rebound off of the miss. Lersman trying to get it inside. Cox the extra feed for Joey Reyes.
And the key concept there is the extra feed, the extra pass. They are brilliant at looking for one another now. They've rattled Arkansas at the defensive end.
Walker goes cross court for Reed. Off of penetration. Book it in a foul.
That's where Arkansas has to play this game a little bit. Utilize that quickness on the offensive end. Put it on the floor and get in the paint area. You got to make people defend. You got to make them react. This is a great point guard matchup we have going with Reed and Oliver really trying to direct their teams and control the tempo of the flow.
T.J. Cleveland will check into the game. Another of those freshmen. He's the nephew of Arkansas assistant Mike Anderson and has been around this program for so many years. Jodeen Davenport, the tight end on the Arkansas football team, will get a breather. Reed trying to complete a three-point play. No good. Takes the rebound. 19-12. Only 12 points for Arkansas as we approach the 9-minute mark of the first half.
The defense keeps coming out. Backdoor.
No look feed. Lewisman just settles. He couldn't bank it through.
He may have hop-stepped on one foot just then.
He did. Traveling is called.
That was a terrific backdoor cut by Settles. And how about the hang time? Here it comes right at us, bang. He goes up the hang, a little spin, and just spins the ball just a tiny bit too much. He traveled before he got the 20. The thought process was there, but the hop was also.
Settles to the bench, and Dr. Tom Davis just continues to make changes.
He dictates the flow of his game by the defensive effort. Big guy right there getting into problems. Jake's a little bit of a trouble. We're going against a quick guy. You got to move away from him. But the tempo has been in favor of Iowa.
And Dean a little shaken up. Brandon Dean grabbing at that left leg.
Well, the big fella, what'd he do? Throw a little knee into him a little bit up the high side, left side. Jake's is a big fella, too, when he puts the body on you.
So Dean goes to the bench, who will be attended to by the Arkansas medical staff. Kareem Reed goes to the free throw line. It's Reed, Cleveland, Walker, Bradley, and Hood. Rucker, Jakes, Range, Lorsman, and McCausland for Iowa. First free throw for Reed. He'll get another.
And Iowa has crept up into the bonus situation, so Arkansas will be going to the line.
One out of two for Reed.
So a situation that they can start using that to their advantage also by plugging it down deep.
Derek Hood on a kick out for Walker. Three-pointer. Pulls up.
Good decision by Hood just then also.
11 points for Chris Walker, the junior. Lersman gave up his dribble.
They look a little unsteady this trip. Let's see if they can regather.
Range inside. Jakes.
3 seconds of a walk, whatever you want to call it. A
couple different things. They called the 3-second violation. It could have gone either way.
There was a menu of choices there for the official.
See, this was just a sloppy opportunity. Three guys around him. He's in there for a long count. And, I mean, if not that, then he could have gotten called for an offensive at some point, too.
That's a buffet. You just go in,
all you can eat.
They decided on the 3-second call. 10th turnover for Iowa, but they lead at 19-16. Reed off for Walker. He's had the hot hand for Arkansas. Bradley can't get it to drop for three. And Pat Bradley is struggling here in the first half. Came in shooting 38% from long range. Rucker. And the follow from J.R. Cox.
Here we go to the races.
Reed leaning in for the layup. And Kareem Reed off of a made basket getting down the floor quickly.
Oliver doing a good job of directing traffic, though.
He's a smart player, Dean Oliver.
Oh, look at this.
Gorgeous ball fake for two.
Two times in a row, Ian, he's come down the floor as a general and has made some terrific decisions.
Third team all Big Ten as a sophomore. Bradley, he put it off the glass and in.
You don't see him in there too often among the big guys. No one stepped across the lane to help out.
Pat Bradley now 1 of 5 shooting. His first field goal. Koch, he can hit it from there. Three-pointer too strong. Rucker offensive rebound, and Iowa reset. McCausland picked up by Walker. Taking their time in the half-court set. Long three, Oliver, short. And it's rebounded by Reed. On the move, Reed, no-look feed for Bradley. Walker, open look at a three. Cox couldn't grab it, Walker does.
Arkansas with two good looks that trip down the floor with their secondary break.
Iowa better hurry. McCausland had a notion. 23-20, Hawkeyes in a fast-moving first half of action. This is Koch in a mismatch with Bradley.
Keeps those elbows down when you make it that swing. That's one of the things Tom Davis has them do is they take the basketball and they swing it by the defender trying to get themselves in a fouling situation.
And the foul called. 10th team foul on Arkansas. Pat Bradley picking up his second personal. And two free throws coming up for J.R. Koch, the senior. Koch is a player who has shown so much improvement over his time spent at Iowa. Actually got booed as a freshman at home games because so much was expected of him. But slowly but surely, he became an option offensively, averaging in double figures this year.
He's worked on his outside shot where he shoots the ball at around 37%, so he becomes a big guy who can step away from the basket.
Gibson and Dean check in for Arkansas. And Jess Settles has come back in for Iowa. Another free throw for J.R. Koch. Timeout. Iowa with the lead, 24-20.
A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS Sports.
Used to be the harder the ball, the farther it went. Not anymore. This is the new Top Flight XL 2000. It's got titanium in the cover for explosive distance. On an average par 4, that's 10 yards longer from tee to green.
Thing is, the XL 2000 has an amazing soft feel. Softness you can feel and hear.
Close to the green? How about close to the pin? The all-new Top Flight XL 2000. Explosive distance, amazing soft feel. It's the best XL I've ever played.
It started as a vacation, grew into a passion, and eventually led to a career. But you had your challenges along the way, like keeping an international organization focused and motivated, or structuring the acquisition of a key competitor. At Arthur Andersen, we help people make those kinds of decisions, and that helps them focus on whatever it is that got them wherever they are. Arthur Andersen, helping in ways you never imagined.
All right, here we are at the University of Arizona, where we're going to prove that people love the taste of Pepsi One.
You don't want to drink that. Here, enjoy the taste. Enjoy the way that tastes.
This is great.
Oh. That was the best stuff ever!
March Madness, you like the way it tastes!
drink it.
Good.
Good. The one is good.
New Pepsi One with a new secret recipe that makes it taste too good to be called diet.
Sir.
When a company that specializes in trucks unveils the most powerful SUV in its class. Introducing the new 205 horsepower Go Anywhere Isuzu Amigo.
We gotta stop letting these things out for test drives.
Arkansas shooting just 30% from the field as we take a look at our game summary. Walker, the high man, with 11 points. And maybe the surprise isn't the fact that Iowa has a lead. They're a quality team, right. But the surprise here has to be the fact that they have been able to contain Arkansas offensively.
Well, you mentioned that number with Walker shooting the basketball from long range. All the other Arkansas players are at 0-for-8, so they've contained the tempo. Their extension full court defense has helped to slow down the pace a little bit on the offensive end for Arkansas.
Iowa with the 24-20 advantage. This is the 4-5 matchup in the West region. Arkansas seeded fourth.
We switch at the defensive end. We have a matchup right now.
Dean the lob. Hood just trying to get involved offensively. And a foul call. Jess Settles was looking for the traveling violation. Instead, he picked up his second personal foul.
Sometimes there's a reason for the travel, and that's because Settles gave him a little two-arm chest bump.
Derek Hood, averaging a double-double this season. Over 12 points, 10 rebounds per game. And he cuts into the Iowa lead.
Didn't play well in the first half of the Siena game. Really didn't need to play well. Came back a little bit better in the second half of that game.
Just 2 points and one board today for Hood. Oliver gets it across.
Good double team. Nice and strong and aggressive. Arkansas uses the hands on the perimeter, too. That's why you'll see that swing just then. You see the swing of the ball past the hands from the Iowa players.
Lersman going behind the back. Nice feed inside. Koch called for steps.
Koch could have gone straight up. I know he had a defender standing there with him, but I think that's when you want to power in.
Ahead of the field, Derek Hood slams it down.
They caught him napping right there. There's no reason in the world you should give up a bucket like that.
First tie of the day with 5:42 to play, first half. Oliver trying to speed ahead. He does across the line. Joey Range trying a crossover, and it came off his leg out of bounds.
Now what we've been talking about,
Range and Reed exchanging some words after the whistle.
The aggressive play is picking up the intensity level. Tom Davis looking for some calls and some work from the officials.
13th Iowa turnover. Hawkeyes, though, don't want to get into this back-and-forth affair with Arkansas.
They don't mind the running, but you're absolutely correct with the Arkansas. I think it's running is a different level with Arkansas, as you see in the last 3:45, a 12-5 run, because they don't want to take a chance of it being ragged up and down.
Controlled fast breaks.
Yeah, if they have them, go for it, but they do not want to do what we've just seen a moment ago.
Cleveland to the outside and Hood.
Back to the matchup here. My matchup, if the ball is... You're guarding the man. It's man-to-man while he's in your area. If he leaves, you fill up the space.
Arkansas looking for its first lead. Hood is fouled from behind by Rucker.
One of the best ways to break the man, the matchup zone, is basically to put it on the floor. That way you bring a defender out, and the rotation down below is usually too slow to get back for the big fellas.
Guy Rucker, a junior, has that big body, 6'10", 270 pounds. But Hood cannot take advantage with his first free throw. Tied at 24. And the first lead of the game for the Razorbacks.
They're looking for double teams.
Inside, Rucker camping out of the lane. Rejected. Count it. It's goaltending.
Good call from the officials. Nice little ball movement. And then you have a situation where he takes a good strong move into the paint.
Iowa regains the lead by one. 4:54 to play, first half, Iowa 26, Arkansas 25. Iowa has led for the majority of the first half. Arkansas grabbed a one-point lead just moments ago, but the Hawkeyes have gotten it back. Cleveland knocks it down for three, the freshman from Birmingham.
It gets them excited when they hit the threes. Let's look at the intensity this trip defensively. Look at the extension.
Arkansas with a two-point advantage, and that's their largest lead.
This is where decisions are important for Iowa.
McCausland getting it inside. Jake's lost the handle. Trying to spin in, and Jake just took a tumble as Brandon Dean grabbed the basketball. It's a tie-up situation. Arkansas will get it on the defensive tie-up.
As much activity as there was on that play, I think it's the right call. Right now, when it comes down, Dean gets in there. He has all ball. He's not grabbing his arm. He's underneath the arm and around on the right side. It's the right call. The official, if you're looking at this play now, the official from the right side of the screen comes in and overrules the call because he had a better angle right in front of Nolan Richardson.
28-26 Arkansas as we come up on 4 minutes to play here in the first half. Razorbacks the 4 seed, Iowa the 5 seed. Gibson a 3. Came up high off the rebound. Joey Range gives it up for Jake's reverse delivery. Tied at 28, Arkansas comes right back. Dean is fouled by McCausland.
That was blistering how fast they got up the floor that trip. Tom Davis did not like the call, but there was a reach in at the very end of that play.
Coming up, Pennzoil at the half. Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg will get you updated on all the tournament news and the scores and highlights. Plus a live look at all the action going on in the NCAA tournament. That's coming up, Pennzoil at the half. Derek Hood back out onto the floor, replacing Joe Dean Davenport. And Brandon Dean will get his second free throw.
He missed that shot. He's a 55% free throw shooter. His shoulders went away from the basket. You want to start to get your shoulders going towards the basket. That's one of his problems. He's got to drift his shoulders towards that basket.
That one spins out. They converge on Oliver.
He's good with the ball, though. He's getting bumped.
Very elusive.
Now look at the pressure. It's okay if you pick up fouls like that because the intensity gets you thinking as a ball handler.
T.J. Cleveland, that's number 2.
You see a little body action. Oliver's actually trying to find the body to get a call here. Watch the close coming in, though. It is strong, it's intense, it's aggressive, and it's a good call from the officials.
And it sends Dean Oliver to the line. The team's leading scorer as a sophomore, 12 points per game. Out of Mason City, Iowa. Both of these teams' young players missing free throws as Rucker goes to the bench. And Jess Settles, the sixth-year senior, enters the game.
In the first-round game, Oliver took over in that second half and had two old-fashioned three-point drives, plays where he converted to free throws, solid effort with the basketball.
Very short on the second attempt. Reed, no-look feed. Went up high to get it.
He was way past high on that one.
Oliver able to spin in. Settles couldn't handle it. Here's Reed. He gets the layup to drop.
Tom Davis wants him to settle down a little bit now. Maybe pass the ball versus this double teaming. Don't dribble it.
32-28. Arkansas and a foul call.
Upstairs we go. The beauty of this play is getting down on the floor, going after it. Good effort to keep things alive, and Reed with the speed at that particular point just outruns everyone.
But T.J. Cleveland picked up his third personal foul. Oliver, 2 free throws. Hits on the first, and Walker comes in for Cleveland.
We knew Dean could get off the floor, but I was pretty impressed with how quickly he got up there for that dunk.
Brandon Dean climbing the invisible ladder. Oh, Oliver knocks down a pair. We've got a two-point game. 32-30. Brandon Dean, acrobatic. Arkansas up by two.
The durable, authentic khaki. You'll wear out before they do.
If you've been thinking about jumping into a rugged new Montana,
I need more room!
Now's a really good time.
Never seen a minivan do that before.
Maybe it's not really a minivan.
Life was more exciting in Montana. Now jump into a rugged Montana with this limited time offer, but get a move on because the train's leaving the station.
Through this door is the power to make the internet come to life. Introducing the Pentium 3 processor. Don't just get onto the internet, get into it. Find out how at intel.com.
Hey, let's talk New York. Let's talk big. Like the new Big New Yorker from Pizza Hut. It's a genuine street corner 16-inch New York-style pizza with 8 big floppy foldable slices that's really, really good. At a price that's very un-New York, $9.99.
The Big New Yorker pizza from Pizza Hut.
Mom's calling Enterprise Rent-A-Car because our car is sick.
Enterprise will arrange to pick you up.
Wow!
Drive you to our place and get you on your way.
Everybody loves to be picked up.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
These two young private eyes have what it takes to be heroes. Maybe it's because they learn from the best.
Can't beat that.
Chuck Norris guests on an all-new Sons of Thunder to CBS tonight.
Saturday on CBS, the LAPD's dream team hits the road to expose the mob, and Sammo and Arsenio could get caught in the crunch. An all-new Martial Law, Saturday on CBS. 32-30, Arkansas with the lead on Iowa, 3:07 to play here in the first half, and finally you see signs of Arkansas beginning to dictate tempo and get into their style of play. Here we go again. Gibson. Koch got a piece of it. Inside, Hood negated. Koch got it a second time. Good presence on the interior as Koch holds on. He's looking for the open man.
Bounce passes are so dangerous against Arkansas.
Lursman, he lost it. Gibson took it away.
Good range behind him.
Reed, the trailer, and he floats it through. That Arkansas pressure beginning to get to Iowa. It's a four-point Razorbacks lead.
Even when you get the ball behind them, or ahead of them, I should say, they come from behind, and they start flicking the ball and going after your dribble.
Settles. Two-pointer, foot was on the line. Can't get the roll. Hood, quick outlet for Reed. Gibson is ahead. Hood settles in to break it up.
A terrific play, nearly hit the rim going by.
Lursman gives up his dribble, and he's forced to take a timeout. The constant pressure from Brandon Dean. 2:10 left, first half. Arkansas with a 34-30 edge, a 20-second timeout called by the Hawkeyes.
And the reason for this timeout with Tom Davis, he wants to kind of reassure his team. Hey, guys, we played well against Arkansas early in this game. We were making good decisions. We weren't getting rattled. Let's try to get back, settle into our sets offensively. From Nolan Richardson down the other end, I am reinforcing just what we've seen over the last 2 minutes. Keep rattling them, keep pressuring them, keep flicking the ball, make them dribble, make them make decisions on a quick basis.
Four-point game. There's no doubt these Hawkeyes are playing hard for outgoing head coach Dr. Tom Davis. He has not made it a public issue, but privately, you know that these players want to win desperately for their head coach. 34-30, under 2 minutes left. Four-point Arkansas lead. Ball knocked out of bounds with a minute 52 to play, and it's going the other way. The Arkansas Razorbacks are trying to take control of this game, which had been controlled earlier by the Iowa Hawkeyes.
The question becomes, as we've touched on here in the first half, is the tempo set. Who can really set this tempo? In the first 8-9 minutes of the half, it was the other side. Nolan Richardson did not have control of it. Iowa had control of it. Now, for the last 5 or 6, Arkansas definitely in control.
In transition, Arkansas has outscored Iowa 16-10. Walker a three. He's got Chris Walker drilling another long jump shot. He's got 14 points. 4 3-pointers.
He's really the one who's stroking the ball from long range. No one else really is a factor for Arkansas.
Arkansas has its largest lead. Rucker to the outside, Oliver.
Let me try to get something down on the blocks again.
This is Rucker establishing position for the bucket.
So you have the size. They're a big team. They have to use Koch down below. Get the big guy Rucker involved again.
Reed off and running. Dixie Duke off the window.
He is so good at hanging in the air and making something happen.
Oliver straight down the middle of the floor, and a blocking foul is called. Brandon Dean took the hit.
Sometimes as you come down the floor, you have to be a little shifty with the basketball. He's shifting it, he's moving it, brings it away from the defender. A couple of guys can just do that once. You pull it away once from the defender, then you have to shoot. He can do it 2 and 3 times down the floor.
Third personal foul on Brandon Dean, the freshman, who is a major talent. Dean Oliver getting on the first free throw. He now has 10 points. With just a shade under 1 minute left, first half, Sergario Gibson checks in to replace Dean, freshman for freshman.
An important minute, too, right now. 39-33. Arkansas is going to look to try to push, see if they can get another quick bucket. Iowa has to try to shut them down and not let them get the transition going for the last minute.
Oliver connects on both free throws. Bauer and Oliver will go to the bench as McCausland comes into the game along with Lersman. Reed gets it across, the all-time assist leader in Arkansas history. The dish off. Derek Good had it knocked down by Jakes. Fight for the loose ball. Hood clears it. Plenty of time to work with. Bradley back on the floor for Arkansas. 15 on the shot clock. Gibson slashing to the basket and a blocking foul. Jakes took the hit. ...39-34, Arkansas. Clock stopped with 38 seconds to play. In the first half, Sergario Gibson to the free throw line. Jacob Jakes, his third personal foul.
The guy was just a tiny bit late getting across the lane. Arkansas has done a better job in the last 5 minutes also, not just settling for long-range shots, but they're taking their quickness at the dribble and going towards the paint area with guys like Reed and Gibson.
Arkansas making a defensive switch with Brandon Davis coming onto the court, replacing Pat Bradley. And Joey Range getting a breather for Iowa. J.R. Koch has returned. Jakes to the bench. Gibson's second free throw. A 3 second difference. Shot clock to game clock. Final moments, first half. Dangerous pass. And Iowa is very lucky that they didn't turn it over.
The intended receiver, I thought that was Oliver just then, didn't realize that ball was lobbed to him. He thought it was lobbed to a guy behind him. There's the big guy. You don't need the big guy, but Koch that time came right back in towards the basketball as a safety release.
About a half a second difference now. Shot clock to game clock. Oliver matched up with Gibson. 16 seconds left.
Try to get something going to the basket.
Oliver with 10. Gives up his dribble. This is McCausland on the outside. Down to 6. Inside, Koch. Couldn't get it to fall off the window. Knocked out of bounds with 2.8 remaining.
Plenty of time to catch and get a shot off. Arkansas wants to talk it over for about 20 seconds or so. And plenty of time to get a shot off. It's got to be a quick hit.
Beginning March 30th, Craig Kilborn brings his unique comedy style to CBS Late Night. Former college basketball player and cable sportscaster and a comedy star. Soon, the host of his own late night talk show. Catch the premiere of The Late Late Show with Craig Kilborn, March 30th, after David Letterman, right here on CBS. So Iowa will have it for the final 2.8 of the first half, trailing 41-34. Early on, the Arkansas Razorbacks just couldn't get into their offense. And Jason Jennings, the 7-footer for Arkansas, will apply pressure out on the baseline.
You want to get this to a guard, Iyeth, and let him be able to dribble if there's no lob.
Well, this is Koch. McCausland at the buzzer. No good. One half of play in the books from Denver. Arkansas has its largest lead, 41-34.
It's actually a good set. They bring the Koch out as a decoy. McCausland comes right back. Look at how wide open he is. Usually he flat out buries that shot.
Mike Mayock is standing by with Arkansas head coach Nolan Richardson. Mike?
Coach, it looked like Iowa did a pretty good job controlling tempo early.
Well, they did. We had to get into our street fight type of game. I thought we did an excellent job once we got into it. You know, the part that really worries me is Derek Hood is back, you know, and he's just playing with nothing but sheer guts right now, and we can't rebound if he's not in the ballgame.
And three-point shot just not dropping today like it did the other night.
Well, we always known that, you know, some days you shoot them, some days you don't. Your defense got to pay off for you.
Well, good luck with that street fight in the second half.
Thank you, sir.
Ian Eagle, back to you.
End of the first half, Arkansas leads it 41-34. Greg Gumbel and Clark Kellogg will be along with Pennzoil at the half after this message and a word from your local station.
On the day I was born, the nurses all gathered round, and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The nurse spoke up, said, "Leave your boy alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone.
The Cadillac Escalade is born. It's good to be the Cadillac.
In Alaska, the only thing better than finding oil is not finding oil still polluting that state 10 years after the Exxon Valdez. 60 Minutes, Sunday.
Craig Kilborn, coming to CBS, March 30th.
You work so hard every day, and when the work day's done, it's time to play. It's time to play Powerball.
When you play Powerball, you help Iowa because Iowa Lottery proceeds support your state. And you give yourself a chance at the next Powerball jackpot.
Ooh, it's time to play Powerball. I don't wait to play.
Are you planning a party? Then plan the ultimate party at Godfather's Pizza.
Throw a birthday party at Godfather. Take the party out of your home and let us worry about the cleanup.
If you're planning a party during a sporting event, no problem.
Choose from over 25 different kinds of pizza and more.
Godfather's is great for company parties and business meetings, too. And we'll even provide the TV and VCR.
Plan the ultimate party at the following Godfather's Pizza location.
Leaders acknowledge the leader, Holmes Murphy.
We're known for home-style cooking and hometown hospitality. In matters of insurance, we get the same kind of quality, comfort, and care from Holmes Murphy. They understand that a rapidly growing company needs to stay ahead. Holmes Murphy's great coverage and excellent service really raised my comfort level.
When you serve the best, you give your best. And that's what Holmes Murphy's been doing for more than 65 years.
Three games across the country, two of them at halftime, and the other one in action in Seattle. Clark Kellogg and I about to fill you in on everything that's going on.
CBS Sports presents Pennzoil at the Half, sponsored by Pennzoil. Specially formulated for today's stop-and-go driving. Stop, go, Pennzoil.
Welcome once again to Pennzoil at the Half, everyone. Greg Gumbel along with Clark Kellogg at halftime. Arkansas 41-34 lead on Iowa. We said there'd be a lot of three-point shots. We didn't say there'd be a lot of them made, but can you imagine where Iowa would be if they hadn't turned the ball over 15 times in the first half?
Those 15 turnovers, Greg, led to 14 points for Arkansas, and then the last part of that first half, Arkansas got the pace revved up more to their liking. That's why they're on top.
Meanwhile, in Seattle, the Stanford team that returned everyone this year, went to the Final Four last year, has trailed Gonzaga from the start. They are into the second half now, and let's take you now to Key Arena in Seattle and join Kevin Harlan and John Sunzold.
Sauer to Manson. Loose inside as Tennessee Gonzaga leads by five on the fly. Santangelo, the fifth, the fly, the flash. Put that up and in. What a play. Santangelo putting in his own miss.
And two Stanford bodies on the floor. Gonzaga being as physical as it can be. Two terrific hoops and much needed hoops for this Gonzaga team by Santangelo.
Pandemonium in Seattle. A 7-point lead by Gonzaga. Sauer to Manson to Reeves. What rotation? Reeves for three. Right down the middle.
All caused by the mismatches inside. Once Manson gets the ball, they have to help Spink down low.
Eight threes by Gonzaga. Two by Stanford. The steal. Lee fires in. Counter for two and a foul on Santangelo of Gonzaga.
All Arthur Lee on that play, Kevin. He came from the weak side, knocked it away from the Gonzaga player. Nobody saw it coming. Take a look at Arthur Lee coming from the backside, and Dench doesn't see anything. Weems smart enough to kick it ahead. The control and the patience and the poise on the break by Lee. Where he comes from. Ditch, not even observing. Santangelo right here trying to make a play. Again, total body control and poise in midair.
Lee, one of the best free throw shooters in college basketball.
We already talked about what he did a year ago. 35 of 35 in the NCAA tournament.
44 consecutive with that drain right there. And this is the closest it has been since the beginning. Paul Santangelo bumped by Lee.
And again, they're making Santangelo and Fromm go inside. No more long jump shots.
Paul, Fromm, and Santangelo.
On screens, you cannot shoot the gap. The Zags will shoot you out.
Foul inside, called on Seton. His second.
And Gonzaga fans react because they've had a lot of fouls called against them inside today.
Stanford, the lone Pac-10 team remaining. Gonzaga, the only West Coast Conference team invited to the dance. 38% shooting for Gonzaga. Stanford at 41. A three by Fromm. Rebound by Stink. At 195 pounds, he is manning the pivot.
He may be thin, but he's very active. Got great footwork.
Paul, wide open three, right between the eyes.
Another big one. Quinton Hall does. He continues to move without the basketball. His second three-pointer this afternoon.
McDonald around the screen. Flying inside. Slammed in by Manson. Where in the world did he come from?
Boy, what energy this guy plays with.
Two-point game. Manson with 10 rebounds. Spit. Fromm, a two-pointer, in and out. Buckle inside, and vacuumed in by Manson.
And Manson was the defender who put a hand in Fromm's face and then goes back and gets the rebound.
Gonzaga on top by 249-47. McDonald. Jousting with Hall. Suffocating defense by Hall. Lee in front. Shot clock at 10. Lee dunking his way inside. Picked up by Hall, racing the other way. 4-on-3. Hall, with all kinds of options, sends it out to Santangelo.
And he found Santangelo late. Santangelo was open for a split second.
Eaton with the spinner. Pulled off the glass by Manson. He's got
back and
forth they go, Gonzaga and Stanford. We will keep you clued in as to what goes on in Seattle. Meanwhile, at the RCA Dome in Indianapolis, second round action in the South, Oklahoma State and Auburn. It's a 3-point lead for the top seeded Tigers. Let's take you right there and join Sean McDonough and Bill Rafferty.
Auburn lead 43-38, just underway in the second half. Auburn, the number one seed in the South, in a pretty tight battle throughout.
Well, Oklahoma State doing a nice job now beating the press and getting something good out of it.
Doug Gottlieb. Now Adrian Peterson. The pull-up from the free throw line.
Boy, they got some perimeter game.
Yes.
If you get Glendon Alexander to open up and feel comfortable, they're right there.
Because Mason is 15, Peterson is 12. If Alexander could heat up, it'd be very tough to stop. Robinson just inside the arc. That's a two.
And that's the high pick was on his left, and then defensively, Doug Gottlieb anticipated going that way. Good crossover move.
And 4 points for Robinson. Ordinarily is in double figures in scoring. 24 times this year, he's reached double figures. Auburn's 4-for-4 from the floor in this half.
Now Peterson should be able to get a shot off against Palmer if they bring it down to him.
Peterson, Coleman jumped out, so Adrian stepped inside the arc and hit a two-pointer.
So Oklahoma State closes to within 3 of Auburn. Still plenty of time to play in the second half in Indianapolis. We want to remind you that coming up at about 6:50 Eastern time, 6:56 to be exact, we'll send you west for 14th seed Weber State against Florida. And then at 7:04 Eastern time in the South, Detroit will tip off against Ohio State. One other note for you. Duke says that Trajan Langdon, who has missed the last 3 games with a sprained foot, will start tomorrow against Tulsa. We'll be on the air at noon Eastern time. Duke and Tulsa will be the first game up tomorrow here on CBS. Now I'll update you on that game in the West where Gonzaga and Stanford are now tied at 49-all, 11-18 to play in the second half. A timeout here and we'll get you back to Denver for second half action in just a moment.
Pennzoil at the Half has been sponsored by Pennzoil. Specially formulated for today's stop-and-go driving. Stop, go, Pennzoil.
I found I was missing all sensation of sight. It was so dark underground, we had seen no light for days. What was visible, how bad was the enemy?
For those who combine a passion for living with a passion for living. The Volvo C70 convertible.
Things just don't mix. Hey! Yeah! Like drinking and driving.
Great moments in college sports make great memories and often inspires great achievement beyond the game. Come see it all at the Hall, the new NCAA Hall of Champions. Place to relive the action, savor the memories, discover what it means to be a true champion, and that might just be the greatest moment sports has ever produced. The NCAA Hall of Champions, opening in downtown Indianapolis in March 2000.
College costs money. That's why I'm getting a basketball scholarship. It's gonna be hard work, but I'll get there. People say I'm too short. Too short like a fox. Oh, I have game.
You may never get an athletic scholarship, but call now to find out how last year 7 out of 10 full-time students received other kinds of aid, more than $60 billion in all.
I carry these guys a little bit. You can't stop me. You can only hope to contain me.
Let's see. CBS is the official network of the tournament, so who's going to have the fastest total online coverage? CBS.Sportsline.com. That makes sense.
Arkansas with the lead at halftime. CBS Sports coverage of the 1999 men's basketball tournament will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
Now, Mr. Wells, we're going to monitor your thoughts. Listen carefully. Your boss wants to have a talk with you. You're being audited. It's 110 degrees in rush hour traffic. You're stuck in a used car. Mr. Wells, a used car. Mr. Wells, are you paying attention?
The address is CBS. Welcome home.
You're young, smart, and the road ahead is filled with choices. Left turn, right turn, heck, what car to drive? How about Chevy Cavalier? All Cavaliers come with standard anti-lock brakes. And now during Chevrolet's Highway 99, Cavalier Coupe comes with 0.9% APR financing or $1,500 cash back. Come in and see your local Chevy dealer today.
Coming to Iowa, the game where superstars are born. Catch tomorrow's superstars at the 22nd annual McDonald's All-American High School Basketball Game at the Hilton Coliseum in Ames. Net proceeds benefit Ronald McDonald House Charities of Central Iowa. Tickets available at the Iowa State Center Ticket Office or through Ticketmaster. It's a great game for a great cause. Did somebody say McDonald's?
Someday there will be a health care plan offering coverage that improves health as well as covers illness. A plan with coverage designed to fit every person. Whether you're part of a group or on your own, younger or older, Someday is here at Wellmark Blue Cross and Blue Shield, the health improvement company. Now, where are you?
You just can't beat the blues.
Back in Denver, Arkansas with a 7-point advantage. Kareem Reed, 13 points on 6 of 9 shooting, the halftime stats. And you know what happened here? Arkansas just wore down Iowa, that street fight that Nolan Richardson talks about. It worked.
It sure did, especially the last 8 minutes of the half. It worked superbly with them, and it also forced the turnovers. That's one of the things Iowa has to make a change and an adjustment in the second half. Protect the basketball better.
We start play, second half, from McNichol Sports Arena. UConn has already advanced to the Sweet 16 with an easy victory over New Mexico. The winner of this game will match up against the top-seeded Huskies in the next round. Walker pulls it out for Reed. Jeffries was in foul trouble in the first half, trying to get it inside to Hood. Out of bounds.
Hood did not expect that to be a pass. He was thinking shot just then, and with all the threes they've taken in the last game and a half, I'd be expecting a three also.
First couple of minutes, so pivotal for Iowa. If Arkansas can go back and forth with that ragged style, Hawkeyes might be in some trouble. Settles, gives it up, but gets it back. Ball fake, jumper, no good. Jess Settles still looking for his first points of the game. He is 0 of 7 shooting. Bradley, an open look, fading away for three.
A little different team when Bradley starts to shoot the ball well. He was 0 for 4 from long range, 1 for 5 on the half.
And now a 10-point cushion for the Razorbacks. This is their largest lead. McCausley. This is Bauer getting it to the interior and Cox couldn't bank it through.
Have to put that one down if they're going to hang around with a quick, spirited bunch of Arkansas players who are looking to really up-tempo this thing again.
Walker pulls the trigger and hits a three.
They were stroking that in the first round game. This is a good timeout by Tom Davis. His team comes out, gives up a couple of quick long-range jumpers. The tempo has changed.
17 points for Walker. Timeout, Iowa.
I'm going to raise you.
Fold. Too rich for me.
Not fold.
couple of things to remember. One, a full house always beats three of a kind. And two, the new Chevy Silverado has the most powerful V8 of any pickup. Chevy Silverado. It's the truck.
Shut up.
As an architect, I think if it can be imagined, it can be built. Dell has the same philosophy, only they didn't just imagine what we needed, they found out. Before they built our servers and workstations and had them installed, they came to see us around the world. Dell pioneered this direct way. They aren't selling me a box, they're selling a smarter way.
Be direct. Dell. Dell workstations use Intel Pentium 3 processors.
Back in the 60s, the straight and narrow wasn't exactly on everyone's mind. For those searching for a more meaningful future, Kemper's long-term approach provided a higher level of financial consciousness. Like Kemper Total Return Fund, where $10,000 invested in 1964 would have grown to a cool $500,000 last December. Far out. Ask your financial advisor about the thinking behind every Kemper fund. Long-term investing in a short-term world.
Robin and I are going to Cooperstown together, and nobody's going to care that I got 98% of the vote and you only got 77.
Yeah, just like nobody's going to care I won more MVP awards, George.
We'll be too busy celebrating with Miller Lite, which tastes great because it's so smooth.
Well, I think it tastes great because of the choice hops.
Are you sure about that, Robin?
Yeah, I'm sure.
98% sure or just 77% sure?
Miller Lite, the great taste of a true Pilsner beer.
That MVP thing's killing you, isn't it?
Yeah.
CBS Sports' exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship is sponsored by the new Chevy Silverado, Kemper Fund, the United States Air Force, and by Dell.
Tournament summary, the SEC, the only undefeated conference so far. Wisconsin coming up with the fewest points so far in this tournament. And here in our game in Denver, an 8-0 run for the Razorbacks. They lead it 47-34. McCausland knocks it down for three.
Missed that jumper at the end of the first half, which could have made a difference for Iowa, but he comes back when they need a big bucket and they get one. Good set.
Kareem Reed on a dish off. Hood couldn't catch it. Out of bounds.
Hood, as we mentioned earlier, has been struggling a little bit with the hip injury. Took a tough fall in the first round game, but has to be ready to catch that basketball. Reed going right at him.
5 points, five rebounds for Derek Hood. Not the kind of numbers that Nolan Richardson has been accustomed to. Senior out of Kansas City, Missouri. Wants to be a math teacher when his basketball career is over. McCausland coming up short. Power the rebound.
Looking for him, though, aren't they?
McCausland a three. Yes.
Wow. He's a stroke. Two out of the last three, but they were beautiful looks.
Third three-pointer of the day for Iowa. Kent McCausland, number six all-time in NCAA career three-point shooting. 45% during his four-year career with Iowa.
Brings back the little guy into the game, is what Nolan Ryan Richardson said about it.
Jumper from Walker, no good, out of bounds, and Arkansas will retain possession with a brand new 35 and a 20-second timeout from Nolan Richardson. 47-40, Arkansas with a lead. Emmy Award winner John Larroquette returns to television as Royal Pain. Don't miss the series premiere of Pain Monday, right after Raymond, here on CBS. So Iowa showing some signs of life here in the second half. Just about 3 minutes gone by since halftime.
And that was a good timeout by Nolan Richardson in Arkansas because they get a little bit out of their sets defensively.
Add some action as Arkansas was trying to inbounds the ball and Chris Walker gets called on a foul.
Amazing how you come out sometimes after timeouts and you guys just don't execute for you. It's like a wasted timeout. We'll see if Iowa can come down and continue the assault from long range.
first personal on Walker. Iowa able to get it across. Koch gives up his dribble. Settles, looking to get going. Just settles, side rim on the long one.
Really struggling. He had good legs underneath him. He was anticipating shot. Starting to think a little bit. He's 0 for 8 from the floor.
Jeffries a three-pointer. Koch the box out. Gets it to Bauer. On the dish off. Extra feed. McCausland from the corner. Tip McCausland another three.
Shooters try to find rhythm. And he has found his rhythm. And he is pumped.
Third three of the day for McCausland. 11 points overall. And a full timeout has been called. 16-20 to play. 47-43, Arkansas.
3-2.
There is a conspiracy spreading across the country. Its members see things no one else can. What they're watching looks like a movie, but it's a movie premiere that can't be seen anywhere else. And they can access thousands of movies a month.
How?
They must possess a technology that is not of this earth.
Who are these people?
Let's get out of here. DirecTV, what are you looking at?
If you're the kind of person who'd rather tune an engine than eat, who reads a tachometer like a love story, for whom the roar of fully blown horsepower is a lullaby, have we got a machine for you? And in the hands of the right mechanic, it'll blow the doors off anything. Aim High Air Force.
Chevy Blazer, like a rock.
Stuck with a flat tire? Not with this tire. Even with no air pressure, you drive to safety. Aquasteel Run Flat. Don't get stuck. Get there.
Give it up. Your colonel's got the moves this NCAA season. Because my popcorn chicken's back at KFC. Crunchy morsels of tender white meat. Try some for $1.99. Go, Colonel. Go, Colonel. The colonel, he the man.
You know, I played Division I college basketball until my senior year. My coach told me I was too selfish and arrogant. Now, I have my own talk show.
Iowa has crept back into this basketball game, and the reason they have is they're starting to shoot from long range. McCausland from the side, letting it rip. Last three out of four for him, and the reaction is superb.
Kent McCausland, 3 3-pointers. 4 made in total for the Iowa Hawkeyes after connecting on 12. Which was a new team record in NCAA tournament play of a first-round victory. A 9-0 Hawkeyes run. Reed trying to settle things down with his team still leading by 4. Bradley dumping it inside, and Hood comes up short.
That's another factor at the defensive end. He's really given Hood problems when Hood turns and looks to shoot a shot. There's always been a hand in his face.
Lorsman on the floor. This is settled.
Lob.
The catch, release, and the deuce for Koch.
Looked like a carbon copy jumper, didn't it, from the other side? Settles did the same thing before. His last trip down, shot the ball from long range. That looked exactly like it.
47-45 Razorbacks, and 11-0 Iowa run. Walker thought about it. Bauer is daring him to take it. Off the fingertips of Jeffries. And Bauer took it away.
Like the tone in the first half. The first 7 minutes of this game is the same exact way this is being played.
McCausland for Lorsman. Lorsman, penetration. Lost it for a moment. And he shuffled the feet, or was it a foul? It's a foul called on Arkansas.
decisions is so important, but here settles with the lob. I'm pretty sure that was a lob. He was missed by a foot, but it looks good. Doesn't look like he's shooting it. Hood thought he was shooting it. Hood turns the rebound. Koch goes right to the basket for the alley-oop.
Chris Jeffries picking up his fourth personal foul. He has not scored here today, the freshman from California. Settles on a turnaround. Got it! Just settles his first deuce.
They're all over it now with this full court action.
Luhrsman, yes!
Defense is supposed to rattle them. They're not supposed to be really rattling Arkansas. Here we go again.
Turning the tables. Oliver got contact. Koch slams it down. It'll be waved off. The foul was called.
Koch should have left that basketball alone too, Ian, because it was hanging up there. I'm not sure if it was going to come out quickly, but the defensive pressure. Iowa comes up. They extend. The careless passes in the middle of the floor. This basketball is hanging. Clearly it was going to come off, so it doesn't really matter that Koch went up there and dunked it through, because that did not count.
Fourth personal foul on Brandon Dean. And Dean Oliver at the free throw line. Missing on the first attempt. Iowa leads it by two. Cleveland will come in for Bradley as Dean remains on the floor. And now Nolan Richardson will make the change. Sergario Gibson checks in for Dean. And another free throw coming up for Dean Oliver.
See, the first 5 minutes of this half, Tom Davis has controlled the tempo. But now Nolan Richardson is putting his other guys in off the bench to kind of get some helter-skelter back into this game.
Reed gets it across for Gibson. Gave up his dribble. Walker off of penetration. Oliver went for the steal and a reach-in foul. 50-47, Hawkeyes. A 16-0 run for Iowa.
I think Iowa lulled them to sleep a little bit in the first 5 minutes of this half, and now they're extending their defense a little bit out to the perimeter.
Any thoughts that Arkansas may be getting tired with the altitude?
No, I don't think so. I think they're very well conditioned. They're using the bench pretty well.
Bam. Up top, Derek Hood. Reed got it to him around the rim.
This trip here will answer your question. Let's see what they do defensively. If they're really aggressively going after. Keep in mind there are a lot of substitutes on the floor too.
Off of the deflection, Oliver driving it to the basket. Couldn't spin it through, but he is going to the stripe.
Where they are so good, they make things happen when you double team and they up tempo. And here's Reed with the delivery to Hood, really going through the defensive double team out on the wings. Iowa has to be careful with that, because if they get broken down from the trap, they'll be in trouble.
More free throws for Oliver, and he gets the roll on the first attempt.
Oliver is very good at coming to the basket with the basketball, dribbling through and slicing, sliding through and slashing.
Kent McCausland getting ready to check in, and give him credit, because he would have been the guy that turned the tide for this Iowa team. They needed a spark of some sort, and it was McCausland from the perimeter.
Absolutely. He rang the alarm for them. There's no question about it. And it's a funny thing, when he got his shot down, he was all pumped up, and they responded.
Arkansas handles the pressure. Gibson pull up, pop, as he knocks it down.
Love to see guys come down the floor, dribble, and stop on a dime and shoot it.
52-51, okay. Iowa. And the step in by Reed. Reed taking it to the basket. The flip doesn't go down. Rucker trying to grab it, and he does.
Iowa dodged the bullet just then.
And a jump ball call. Rucker had possession, and they call the defensive tie-up.
The ball is down for grabs. I almost said up for grabs, and then a little reach around the side. I'm not sure if there's a hand on the basketball just then.
It's barely touching.
Yeah, absolutely.
One of the other officials had a foul called, but Zelton Steve blew his whistle first.
It'll change again now. Matchup zone.
Walker can't hit it for three. Luhrsman.
Decisions off the dribble.
Inside, Jake had it knocked away. That wasn't pretty going to the rim. But Iowa will hold on to it with 27 seconds left on the timer. settles into the game for Iowa. And Oliver comes back in after a quick breather. Lorsman goes to the bench along with Rucker. Up top for Jakes.
Better job there finding McCausland on the in the corner.
Iowa up by one. Settles, guarded by Walker. 15 to shoot. Joey Range out on the floor for Iowa.
Somebody will have to put the ball on the floor and try to go around the Arkansas defender out front.
Oliver looking to make something happen. Shot clock down to four. Stutter step. Bounce pass inside. Settles. He saved it, but a violation. One too many dishes for the Iowa Hawkeyes.
The thought process was good, too, by Dean Oliver, but it was a bounce pass in the lane right at someone's foot.
Kareem Reed driving ahead for two.
Settles slipped also down the floor, and that made it even easier for Reed. Look at this pressure coming after them.
Arkansas has regained the lead. Oliver up ahead. Joey Range taking it strong. Rebound, Settles, swatted by Hood. Tracked down in the corner by Walker. Walker, the pull-up jumper. And rebounded by Settles.
The altitude will take effect now. This is up and down. It's ragged. These guys are going to be tired in another 30 seconds.
Spread the floor now. Range giving the look.
Let's see how they cut now. See if they're tired. This is cutting to the basket. The motion without the ball. Let's see if it's sharp or slow.
McCausland. Mismatch with Hood. McCausland, three-pointer. No good.
Legs start to go when you're tired. Shots become more difficult.
Offensive rebound. Joey Range gets the deuce. Iowa with a one-point advantage.
Arkansas has this in the pace that it wants, though, Ian, right now. They're going up and down. That's how they want to play this. Nolan Richardson said the street fight.
It's Kareem Reed with a three-pointer, and it's rebounded by Oliver. Oliver flips it up. Settles the tap. No. Jakes is looking for the basketball, but Walker saves it for Reed. Two-on-one developing with Cleveland. Cleveland the drive. Didn't get it to drop. McCausland the rebound.
Put a hand in there. It was a terrific reaction defensively.
Joey Range lines it up. Hits it for three.
Joey Range is the only guy with legs out there right now. He's getting some strength jumping.
12 points for the freshman.
He's breathing hard, though, too.
And a 20-second timeout has been taken.
That really benefits Iowa, that timeout.
11-12 to play. We are in the second half, and Iowa with a 57-53 lead.
That was lightning quick there for about eight trips back and forth.
First couple of minutes of the second half, Jimmy, it looked like Arkansas was just going to take this game by the throat and cruise in for a win until Kent McCausland hit three three-pointers. Iowa now in front by four. Coming up, more NCAA tournament action. Weber State running that Cinderella label right now. They take on Florida. And Detroit against Ohio State. That's coming up.
Catch our breath right now. That was the message in those timeouts. Catch your breath and start it up again.
Half court set for Arkansas. Cleaver, three-pointer. Book it.
Good step there. Arkansas in the timeout. Gets something. The last time they had a timeout, they did not execute well.
T.J. Cleveland, 45% from long range this season. He has 6 points.
Nice little move by Rucker in the middle of the floor, not dribbling the basketball as a big guy.
Bauer, defended by Bradley, makes his move. This is Rucker with the jump shot. In and out.
Nope, you can't do that.
Cleveland caught it, and he's called for traveling.
You catch it, fall to the floor, they'll hit you with that one.
Have to get rid of the basketball before you slide on the hardwood. It's a one-point game. J.R. Koch, rainbow shot, no good. Jodeen Davenport with the rebound on the inside.
Last two shots that have missed by Iowa have been soft and right on the money.
Another open look, Cleveland, same spot, different result. And it's rebounded by Lorsman.
Taking a little longer to get down the floor for these guys right now in the breaks.
Quick passes for Iowa. Hutch tried to take the baseline.
He's got Bradley down deep, too.
Lorsman the jump shot. Short. Rebounded by Cleveland. Here comes Arkansas. Razorbacks on the move with Reed. Scoop shot. Couldn't spin it in. Bauer trying to rebound the ball. And he was forced out of bounds by Reed.
Bauer hustled down the floor that trip and got himself in very good defensive position. Watch what Reed has to do. He takes an easy shot and now turns it into a hard one because Bauer got down the floor and then Reed tips the basketball out of his hands. Good call from the official. Nice play by Bauer.
McCausland gets it in for Lorsman. Iowa committed 16 turnovers in the first half. Only three so far in the second half of action, and we are past the midway point.
That's the key against pressure defense. If you have to put the ball on the floor, you must make good decisions when they react.
Into the post. Drucker had it deflected by Davenport. Out of bounds. 16 seconds remain on the timer. Substitution for Iowa. Dean Oliver in. Lorsman goes to the bench.
So important now with the coaching to get guys in and out of the game so you know you have fresh guards handling the basketball. You do not want them to be worn out and try to handle the basketball in situations like this.
57-56 Hawkeyes. Spread the floor. Oliver picked up by Cleveland. Five to shoot. McCausland. Koch. Once again, too many passes. No violation because they turned it over. Arkansas pushing it up. This is Gibson. Cleveland on a pump fake.
Iowa back in that matchup, but they're lost in the corner.
Gibson a three. He moves without the basketball. Iowa could not find him. And Sergario Gibson makes them pay.
They set a little token screen in the baseline cut. And that's why he was wide open.
Arkansas up by two.
Now you have to get your legs under you. Play hard, catch your breath, and go sharply with the basketball both ends of the floor.
Bauer on the drive, and a foul called, blocking foul. It's Cleveland.
You get down the other end of the floor, you see the Gibson running the floor in the middle, finds a spot. Good little screen down low, and Iowa slow to react defensively.
Fourth personal foul called on T.J. Cleveland.
He'll bring it down.
He did. Walker with the steal. Ahead of the field as he rocks the rim.
Quick guys, when you're a big guy, you do not want to bring the basketball down on a catch down to the chest level or below.
19 points for Chris Walker. Iowa trying to deal with this Arkansas pressure. Oliver on a stop and go. They turned it over.
Here's the strip. Walker so quick and off to the races he goes. Nice little handle. That's what they want to get. They want to get the quick turnover and push down the floor. These guys are breathing hard right now.
21 turnovers for Iowa. They trail Arkansas 61-57.
Good pass over the top.
Reed, his battery just keeps on ticking. Bradley, long jump shot. Davenport taps it to the outside, controlled by Bauer. Arkansas is ready defensively. Bauer trying to find an opening. Inside, Jakes. Little pump fake for Jacob Jakes.
A good stop, too, just then for Jakes. If he rolls to the basket, he runs over Bradley. He stopped, pulled up jumper, perfectly done.
Timeout, 7:58 left. Arkansas holding on to a two-point lead.
A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS Sports.
Mrs. Faree is teaching geometry at Maxwell Middle School.
And when I get to school, I have kids actually waiting at my door.
They're making designs using Microsoft PowerPoint that they turn into mosaics on the school's picnic tables.
Everything that they learn is something they can use in real life, and then you can make it grow. And
technology is helping these kids develop the skills they will need in life.
I hope that the kids don't just say, "You are my favorite teacher." They say, "I learned something from you."
Chris Wirth. Earth, animator, knows good, knows evil, knows that having a formidable partner is definitely good. Chevy S10, like a rock.
It knows two speeds. Stop and go. It just beat a series of the toughest stop-and-go driving tests in the world, and it's brand new. Go ahead. Guess. You have 4.3 seconds. Introducing Pennzoil with new Pure Base. Stop. Go. Pennzoil.
Cellular One, clear across America.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? Very simple. No stress.
We'll be happy to.
They arrange to pick me up free, so I don't have to ask anyone for a ride. See? No stress.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Tonight on CBS, America's Night of Heroes, beginning with Martial Law and then followed by Sons of Thunder. That's tonight on CBS. Our game summary: in a two-point game, Arkansas in front. Field goal percentage right around the same number. Turnovers, that has hurt Iowa. Fast break points, very close. Not what we expected heading into this matchup.
And Iowa has taken advantage of some of those opportunities.
Cleveland gets it across. Finds Hood for the uncontested dunk.
That's where Iowa has to be careful, though, with their upfront trap. If they get beaten, they're really getting beaten down deep. Right at the other end of the floor, though, Arkansas comes back with their version of it.
Oliver getting around Hood and a touch foul call. Stops the clock with 7:39 left.
How are you going to defend this? Cleveland pushing, Hood finishing. It is quick.
First foul called on Derek Hood. And a four-point Arkansas cushion. Oliver defended by Reed. Settles, fires it inside. Jake
wasn't there, though.
He was trying to bounce it to Joey Range. Out of bounds.
That was a very good thought, too. I don't think Range saw the ball coming around two players.
Cleveland hurries it across. Walker lines it up for three. He connects.
They're starting to stroke it when they need it. I think I'd pull that full court pressure off if I were Iowa right now.
22 points for Chris Walker. Six trifectas. McArthur counting a three-pointer. Reed wasting little time. 66-62 Razorbacks.
Every time the half-court game comes into effect for Arkansas, Iowa can get their breath a little bit on a collective basis.
I think everybody's just trying to get their breath on a collective basis right now.
Down to five. Cleveland.
Recognize the clock either. I don't think he knew there was only five left.
Razorbacks turn it over with 6:31 showing on the clock. Again, wholesale substitutions. Three players come in for Dr. Tom Davis. It's Lorsman, McCausland, Koch, Settles, and Bauer for Iowa. Outside, McCausland spots up. Hits another three.
You talk about finding the guy who has a hot hand. That was a very delayed break and a terrific lookout for the wide-open long-range shot.
17 points for Kent McCausland. 5 3-pointers.
Good look for Walker just then, the same type of set.
Settles the rebound off the miss. Inside, Koch got some contact from Walker and a foul.
McCausland giving up the basketball that trip on the break. The applause from Tom Davis. Very happy with the way they're battling back, sticking around. I love the pace of this game. It's a terrific battle.
Both of these teams working very hard, but you have to respect Iowa's heart because there have been a couple of occasions where you thought maybe Arkansas could run away with it, but Kent McCausland And his long-distance prowess has kept the Hawkeyes alive. Not only alive, but very much in this game. Koch missing on the free throw. Walked away from the line. That's a problem.
Stay on the line, especially when you're tired. Get the shoulders going towards the basket, not away.
Bradley in for Walker. And now Brandon Dean will come in for T.J. Cleveland. So Arkansas up by one. First half, McCausland limited to just 2 points. Koch, second free throw.
Stayed on the line that trip. Did not fall away.
We are tied at 66.
Hood came very close to having that basketball graze off his leg as it went out of bounds. Let's see if Arkansas can get by the first two guys up front for Iowa. If they do, they have better numbers. They're by it now. Let's see what happens.
Dean on the attack. Iowa trying to recover defensively. They do.
Back to the matchup zone.
Gibson gives it up. Reed, three-pointer. Too strong. McCausland, the rebound. And he gets it off for Lorsman.
That's good coaching. I think that makes a whole lot of sense to fall back into the matchup, force the game on the outside to the perimeter with Arkansas now, see if their legs are underneath them.
Lorsman. Knocks it down. Ryan Lorsman from long range.
The guards are playing on the string. The string meaning when one comes towards you, you flare away from them to give yourself some space. Boy, they're executing well.
Well, Nolan Richardson said he wanted a street fight. He's getting one. Out of bounds. Did he get the timeout? Yes. Derek Hood falling out of bounds, got the timeout, and it stops the clock. Just over 5 minutes to play. Iowa leads by three.
Oh.
America's got gumption.
Ain't nobody crying.
The kind of can-do spirit that's in every Chevy Malibu.
Ain't nobody worried.
A car so carefully crafted, so darn tootin' tough, it can go up to 100,000 miles before its first scheduled tune-up. Yes, sir, it's gumption on wheels. The car you knew America could build. Malibu. Genuine Chevrolet.
Oh, I hate you now.
Bud Light.
Aren't you forgetting something?
Oh, my wallet.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Oops, I'll get it. Oh.
We've got a level 9. Quarantine it all. It's all hot. Take it away.
Is full of late show laughs with Tom Hanks, George Clooney, Sandra Bullock, Craig Kilborn, Bill Murray, and Monday. Don't miss International Man of Mystery, Mike Myers.
Back in Denver, let's go to the data bank. Arkansas has made at least one three-pointer in each of their last 365 games. Have to go all the way back to January of 89 against Texas, the last time they did not connect for three. Iowa with a 69-66 lead, just over 5 minutes to play. Three-point shooting so far. Iowa, 8 of 18. They have really turned it around in the second half. Arkansas with 10 three-pointers. Right now, let's check in with Mike Mayock.
I and I had a chance to listen to Tom Davis there during that timeout, and he was very emotional, said every rebound, every loose ball has to be ours. We're 5 minutes from Phoenix. The juxtaposition was Nolan Richardson, very calm, talking about double-teaming defensively, and he said, fellas, bottom line, if we're aggressive, we go to Phoenix. Back to you, Ian.
McCausland, a little bit out of control. He lost the ball.
Decisions right now, so important.
Bradley for the tie. No good. Bauer tried to get it over the back of Hood. Arkansas controls it. Walker, this could tie it up. Short.
Look down the floor. Oh, what a play!
Oliver gets it to Jess Settles for the slammer.
Settles stuck out. What a play by Oliver. Wrap around behind the back pass.
Iowa extends its lead. 71-66. Counting down to the four-minute mark here in Denver. The winner with a trip to the Sweet 16 against UConn, the top seed in the West.
Down 5, 4 minutes or so left. You have to start going deeper to the basket, I think. Not long range.
Hood, the discard. Settles was in there as well. And the foul was called.
If there's a prettier pass to be made in the NCAA tournament this year, I can't wait to see it, because this is a beauty right here. The wraparound behind the back pass. What court awareness by Oliver to trigger that one to catch Settles ahead of the floor.
Jess Settles called on the personal foul, number 3.
Let's see if Arkansas can get something going towards the basket.
Cleveland, skip pass.
Matchup defense right now.
Reed on a shake and bake, penetration. Ball knocked to the outside and Bauer. Arkansas not hitting its shots.
Better decision though there from Reed and Arkansas.
Arkansas out of timeouts. Io with a full and a 20. 71-66, Hawkeyes. Settles puts it on the floor, and Reed is called for the foul.
It's a 77% shooter at the line, 6-year vet.
Iowa on a 12-0 run over the last 3:35. They can add to it with Jess Settles. He's been dreaming about this moment. Had to sit out a couple of years because of back problems. Nobody thought the NCAA would grant him a rare sixth year of eligibility. He's here, and he misses on the free throw. 5-point game.
Iowa can continue to be aggressive defensively also. They only have 2 team fouls.
Bradley at 3. Oh, did they need that one?
Oh, did they ever, because he had been asleep with his shooting, just not really having a stroke today. Puts him back in the hunt.
8 points for Pat Bradley. Lorsman gets it to the outside. Looks like Iowa looking to slow it down.
I wouldn't go too slow, though. I'd still get into my sets, because you don't want to get lulled into sleep and be forced to take a bad one if the shot clock works against you. Keep looking for opportunities. They're playing well.
Lorsman matched up with Cleveland. Shot clock at 13. Lorsman short on the jump shot.
Not a good shot. Little rattles. You don't want to get rattled.
Settles steals it away, and he's fouled by Bradley.
The beauty of Jess Settles right now, Ian, is that he has not played a good game in terms of shooting the basketball, but it has not affected what he's doing in terms of his floor work. Here you see him come in with the double team. Jake's right there to make a stop on Bradley. He has no choice but to foul him.
Jess Settles, the 19th foul called on Arkansas. Settles shooting a pair. Connects on the first. His mom and dad, the Settles family, making the trip from Winfield, Iowa. And Settles will get a second toss. He can give Iowa a 4-point lead. He does. Substitution. J.R. Koch in. Settles to the bench.
The way this game has been played with 2:42 left, there'll be plenty of opportunities still, so it's an eternity in this basketball game.
Cleveland, long pass for Hood. Gets it into the hands of Reed.
Extra pass on the left wing.
And a foul called. Koch was trying to log up the middle with Derek Hood.
Hood was rotating with the basketball. As the ball was swung from the left side, Hood rotated and Cox grabbed it.
In the final 2:33, we will see if the Arkansas seniors can step forward during crunch time. Reed gets it in for fellow senior Hood.
The last play, too, Iron, was an example of not hurting yourself with team fouls.
Reed, a three. Hook it.
Did you say something about veterans stepping up?
Kareem Reed now with 18 points. One-point game. Oliver dribbles out of trouble.
As good as he is with the basketball, he has to be careful also, dribbling the ball around Reed.
McCausland.
Pick it up, you're in trouble also.
Knocked out by Reed. It was close.
Are they fast? You pick the basketball up near a double-team situation, and they just jump all over it.
2:01 left, and a timeout has been called. We've got a one-point game in Denver. More to come.
If this is you, communications has finally caught up with the way you live. Introducing AT&T Personal Network. All the ways you want to communicate in one network. Long distance, calling card, even wireless. It doesn't matter. Because now they're at the same low rate of just 10 cents a minute, plus internet access. So call 1-800-4-ATT-NOW or visit our website, AT&T Personal Network. 10 cents a minute, no matter how you call. Call 1-800-4-ATT-NOW.
Somewhere east of Prague, north of Budapest, and 700 years in the past, there's a town whose streets haven't gotten wider since the Middle Ages. Good thing there's the agile and durable all-new Chevy Tracker. If it can handle the cramped quarters of this medieval town, it can fit just about anywhere. If you know where the Tracker is, you could win it. For more Tracker information, or to enter, click here. The all-new Chevy Tracker. It gets around.
Hey, let's talk New York. Let's talk big. Like the new Big New Yorker from Pizza Hut. It's a genuine street corner 16-inch New York-style pizza with 8 big floppy foldable slices that's really, really good. At a price that's very un-New York, $9.99.
The Big New Yorker pizza from Pizza Hut.
Are you concerned about losing more hair? Do you wonder how much further it will go? Do you wish you could do something about it? Well, there's a pill for men with certain types of hair loss. It's called Propecia. In clinical studies, the vast majority of men, 83%, maintain their current hair count, and most, 66%, regrew some hair. Take it daily and you could see results in as little as 3 months. Propecia is for men only. A small number of men experience certain sexual side effects. Each occurred in less than 2% of men. Women who are or may potentially be pregnant must not use it or handle broken tablets because of the risk of a specific kind of birth defect. Talk to your doctor or pharmacist and read the consumer information they can provide. Propecia, helping make hair loss history.
The LAPD's dream team hits the road to knock out big rig mobsters.
I was almost trailer trash.
All new Martial Law, CBS Tonight.
2:01 left. Second half, Iowa with a one-point lead. Our CBS Sports Line stat of the game. This one may come down to a three-point basket down the stretch. Dr. Tom Davis taking that timeout. Wise decision?
I think it was to regroup. You have the basketball. You have a one-point lead. Regroup. Because decisions are going to be so important here.
And they have one 20-second timeout remaining.
Arkansas with 9 fouls. So you want to try to get something going to the basket if you're Iowa. Get that double bonus working in your favor.
Shot clock at 9. Oliver. Wild shot. It's tipped in. J.R. Cox. Down to 1:42 to play. 75-72. Hawkeyes. Cleveland the three. Can't hit. Cox the rebound on the weak side. And a foul call with 1:34 to play. And Iowa nursing a three-point advantage.
Oliver did not realize that he had a layup right there on the other side of the basket. He tries to be a fancy move. Flip it back up. Cox right in the correct spot at the right time. Stretch this to a two-possession game right now.
And two shots for J.R. Koch. The fourth personal foul on Pat Bradley. Koch at the line. A couple of key free throws. connects on the first. Foul trouble. Jakes, Koch, and Settles, three apiece. Dean, Jeffries, and Cleveland, along with Bradley, all have four.
Now after this shot, they'll come down the floor in a hurry.
Koch, two out of two.
Still have plenty of time. If I'm Arkansas, I try to get this thing going to the basket as quickly as I can. It looks like they may settle for a three.
Cleveland. Out for Walker. Cleveland.
Arkansas does not have a timeout, remember, so they have no chance to regroup at the bench. They have to do it on the floor.
Walker swings it in for Hood. But a foul is called.
The last minute has belonged to Koch. At the offensive end with the tip. Watch him step across now. Get good position. Feet down. He's vertical. He's okay. Hood puts the shoulder down a little bit. Tough call to go against Hood, though. They needed a bucket.
Nolan Richardson disagreeing with the call. This is a five-point game.
Have to go for the steals. At some point, you're going to try to foul, too.
Coming up on 1 minute left. McCausland gets it over to Bauer. Bauer splitting defenders. Oliver holds. Spreading the floor. Iowa using up clock. Oliver defended by Bradley. Hood comes out. This is Settles. Down to 50 seconds left. And finally the foul as Reed forces Settles to the ground.
13 seconds were on the shot clock. If you're going to decide to foul, you must foul much earlier than that. It's a five-point basketball game. 20 seconds plus were just eaten up off the clock, and you eliminate some of your chances.
And Jess Settles is going to the free throw line. Gonzaga has defeated Stanford. The number 10 seed in the West goes to the Sweet 16. Settles hitting on the first. 78-72. 50.4 seconds left. Iowa with a six-point lead on Arkansas. The five seed in front. Jess Settles tacking on another point with the free throw. They lead it 79-72.
It's three possessions also. They come in a hurry, but they have to go and shoot at long range quickly.
Bradley at three. No good. Rebounded by Hood on a kick out to Reed. And a steal by Oliver. Oliver on a race to the rim. The layup. He gets the layup.
Boy, if the Hawkeyes answered the charge at the end of this basketball game.
That may have sealed the deal for the Iowa Hawkeyes.
Reed gets a little careless. Oliver down. We saw him do this in round one. Finishing it off. He had two of those plays in round one.
The Iowa Hawkeyes under Coach Tom Davis have taken over this game over the last couple of minutes of play. With the free throw and a three-point play, giving Iowa a 10-point lead.
The lack of timeouts for Arkansas just really hurt them because they could have used one to regroup.
And a foul is called on McCausland.
Good foul. They're just looking to take time off the clock right now. They have 14 fouls. So they can continue to do this if they so desire for maybe another time if they want. 31.9 seconds. I don't think they will unless they get in trouble.
The jumper from Reed is short. Rebounded by Koch. Final seconds. And the Iowa Hawkeyes will advance on to the Sweet 16 for the first time since 1988. Time ticking away.
This is going to be a very emotional finish for Iowa.
Dr. Tom Davis will coach another game for Iowa. And it is over here in Denver. Iowa is going to Phoenix. Hawkeyes win it 82-72. And a Sweet 16 meeting with the UConn Huskies, the top seed in the West. Fifth-seeded Iowa knocks off number four-seed Arkansas. These players have rallied around head coach Tom Davis, who will be moving on at the end of Iowa's run in this tournament. Stepping down as head coach, resigning. But he is leaving with a bang. The reaction of Tom Davis. Huddling up with his assistant coaches. His wife looking on. And Iowa Rebels defeated Arkansas 82-72, the final. Earlier today, UConn moved on with an easy win over New Mexico. And then Iowa, the 5 seed, tops Arkansas for a Sweet 16 appointment with the Connecticut Huskies. Arkansas led this game 47-34 when Iowa went on a 16-0 run to bring them right back into the contest. And the celebration continues for the Hawkeyes. Our Chevrolet MVPs, players of the game, Kent McCausland, 17 points, and pivotal three-pointers when Iowa desperately needed it. Chris Walker is the Chevrolet player of the game for Arkansas in a losing effort. For Jim Sparkle and Mike Mayock, that'll do it from Denver. 82-72, the final. Iowa wins it for Coach Tom Davis. Greg Gumbel coming up from the studio when we return.